Just 3 years after his arrival in the Big Apple, 2022's NBA free agency has been abruptly paused due to the headlining news of Kevin Durant requesting a trade out of Brooklyn. There's been rumors swirling that the LA Lakers could trade for both Durant and Kyrie Irving, while the Toronto Raptors could acquire KD for a package that Brooklyn would have a hard time turning down. Stay tuned for the details on those potential blockbuster trades involving a top 2-3 player in the world. Right quick, only 14.7% of you watching right now are subscribed, so if you haven't yet, please subscribe and hit the bell, plus drop a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at DFlowHoops and I'll follow you back. Links down below in the description for those two platforms. As Chris Haynes said today on NBA TV, Kevin Durant's not about the drama off the court, he's about strictly basketball, and the Nets just didn't have a stable situation around him. It's amazing how the Brooklyn Nets franchise fumbled three generational players in the span of 1 year. However, GM Sean Marks can revitalize his team by receiving an assortment of young prospects and draft picks in return for his unhappy superstar. While the Raptors weren't one of the teams Kevin requested to be traded to, ESPN's Zach Lowe said that Masai Ujiri and the Raptors should be the first call the Nets should make. Playing in the six would provide an opportunity for Kevin Durant to play in a championship-winning organization. While Scottie Barnes was mentioned in the deal to acquire Durant, the Rookie of the Year is untouchable in my personal opinion. Toronto would be more willing to part ways with 22-year-old center Precious Achiuwa. They could package him with an all-star caliber two-way player in OG Anunoby and top it off with one of the NBA's best bench big men who they could sign and trade to Brooklyn in the stretch center Chris Boucher, along with a future first-round pick. Brian Windhorst says a lot of things, and one of them was proposing a potential scenario where the LA Lakers could deal for both Kyrie Irving and Kevin Durant. Now, this seemed insane to me at first, I'm not going to lie, but then I realized how the Lakers could legitimately make the money work in this deal by giving up both Anthony Davis and Russell Westbrook in exchange for those two. Talen Horton Tucker is a young asset that would be included in the deal. The Nets would also receive a few draft picks in this potential Durant to Los Angeles trade, picks which could be valuable down the line, considering the age of LeBron and how Kevin has a history of constantly moving on from teams. But just imagine a roster consisting of Kyrie Irving, Kevin Durant, and LeBron James. Now, the chemistry off the court could be nightmarish, considering KD just requested a trade to get away from Kyrie. But stopping those three, who can all easily get their own shot off the dribble, would be a problem for anyone. For Brooklyn, this would be your best option if you're trying to tank, but who knows, maybe two former All-NBA players in Westbrook and Davis could make some noise for Brooklyn next year. The Miami Heat were one of Durant's preferred trade destinations, and the addition of Kevin would be scary for me personally as a Raptor fan. The roadblock for this trade is that Bam Adebayo isn't currently eligible to be moved because of the designated rookie extension rule, which states that a team can't have two players acquired via trade who were signed to that type of extension, and Ben Simmons of the Nets falls under that category as well. To me, that harms the likelihood of the Heat getting KD, but Pat Riley still does have Tyler Hero and 19-year-old Serbian forward Nikola Jovic, who was the team's first-round pick in last week's draft. Miami can also include an unprotected first-rounder in 2023 and 2028 in that deal. The Boston Celtics just swept Kevin Durant in the first round, and the Nets could be hesitant to do business with the C's, considering they were robbed back in that 2012 blockbuster, which saw Boston steal a few first-rounders in exchange for Paul Pierce, Kevin Garnett, and Jason Terry. Those picks turned into Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown. As GM Brad Stevens has said, the team needs more scoring, but the question is, would Durant mess up what this team already has going, given Boston's coming off an Eastern Conference title? The Celtics trading for Durant would likely mean giving up Jaylen Brown, which I don't think Boston should do. The Celtics have young assets like Rob or Grant Williams as well, but again, the best course of action for Boston is to run it back with the successful core they've got. Damian Lillard posted this photo on his Instagram story of Durant next to him in a Blazers uniform, and come to think of it, the Portland Trail Blazers could have a real chance to get KD. We'll get to the potential details of a trade, but the last time Durant paired next to a top point guard, he won back-to-back championships, And if there's one point guard in this league that's anywhere close to the level of Stephen Curry, it's the bona fide superstar Damian Lillard. Dame time and Durant could be a reality if the Blazers are willing to part ways with, of course, several first-rounders, plus young players like Anfernee Simons and their recent top 10 pick, Shaedon Sharpe. Moving on to the Phoenix Suns, who were listed as one of Kevin's preferred destinations, and a team composed of Durant, Chris Paul, Mikal Bridges, and DeAndre Ayton would have a solid chance at winning the Western Conference. The Valley would be a great situation for Durant, but this deal sort of broke down when the Nets made it clear they wanted Devin Booker in return for Durant, then the Suns almost immediately extended Booker. So I don't think Durant to Phoenix is going to end up materializing because of that. But which team has the best assets to acquire KD in your opinion? Top 3 commenters with the most shoutouts by September 21st earn a free shoe, the top 5 earn a free jersey. Today's shoutout goes to Jonathan Malikton, who says Christian Coloco reminds him of a hybrid of Ibaka and Capella. Ibaka, because he's good off the pick and roll, and if he works on his jumper, he's going to have so much ceiling and offensive tools. On the defensive end, he has the rim protection of Ibaka and Capella with the size and length. Appreciate every answer. Leave your take on today's question to compete in Community Speaks. D-Flow signing off.